This behind me is the kind of picture you're probably familiar with, or at least you know what's being indicated here. Such is the impact that the monsoon, or the lack of it as depicted in this picture, can have on India and in particular Indian agriculture. But why is that the case? Why are the monsoons so critical in India? Let's look at the basics. We have a couple of types of monsoons in India. One is the southwest kind that pours from June to September, and the other is the northeast kind extending from September to October. Now, about 75% of all the rainfall we get in a year comes from the southwest winds. And we should be thankful for these rains because about 48% of the food crop area depends on the rains, while that number is even higher for non-food crop area at 68%. The southwest monsoon gathers form a little like Rohit in this Cricket World Cup during the months of June, July and August. Now that's the rain bit. What about agriculture seasons? Here again, there are two. One is Kharif and the other is Rabi. Kharif is the summer crop for which sowing begins around June and harvest is done in October. Rabi is the winter crop, with sowing kicking off in December and harvest throwing returns in April. With that out of the way, let's look at what's been the monsoon situation in India. What we've got over the years is near normal amount of rainfall every year. Yet, since 2013, some parts of the country have received deficient rainfall. And that's been an issue. Because it's not enough to have normal monsoons alone. What is also required is even and widespread rainfall. Let me illustrate this quickly with one example. In 2017, Tamil Nadu received excess rainfall owing to the southwest monsoon. But that had little impact on agriculture production because the state depends more on the northeast monsoon, which starts in October. Similarly, a normal amount of rainfall with, say, heavy pouring in September does not help, as the crop would have been starved of water during July and August. But this scenario can help, say in another way, it can help improve the soil moisture for the Rabi crop, which is exactly what we've seen happen in recent years. Again, normal rains during the rainy season need not necessarily be enough. Rains before the monsoons can help improve soil moisture, in turn, improving the prospects of a crop. All the coffee lovers out there, coffee production actually gets affected quite a bit with deficient pre-monsoon rainfall. And that's a lesson right there on how the monsoon affects Indian agriculture. And now just think, if we have a good rain year, nearly 60% of India's rural households depend on agriculture. So they will reap the benefits of it. A good crop that goes for a good price would mean that farmers will have much more money to spend. And when they do that, you get a good buoyant rural economy. Now this obviously positively impacts Indian economy. But what we instead got last year was 9% less monsoon rainfall than normal. And this is what is expected this year as well, with private forecaster SkyMet predicting below normal rainfall this year. But well, now you know what the implications of that could be. We have more videos coming up for you that will look into Indian agriculture, what affects it, what doesn't, what needs to be done, and so on. All we request of you is like and share our video and please subscribe to our channel. There are plenty of things under the sky to discuss on video, even when it's raining outside.